You've got to be kidding. These are your friends? They're the dregs of Giga City.
Zero, wait!
Huh? Shadow betrayed us, remember? The roids here could go maverick and turn into enemies at any time. I'm sure you have your reasons, but I'm gonna work alone.
He just needs time to adjust. He'll come around.
It's too bad Zero doesn't believe in us. Maybe we can find some way to change his mind. Oh! Incoming transmission. Colonel Redips.
Do you read me, X? Were you able to make contact with Zero?
Zero is alive, but he says he'll work alone.
I see. I'm sure he's got some kind of plan. Try not to dwell on it. In the meantime, we've received intelligence regarding a crucial rebellion army facility. Have a look at this. It appears to be a secret rebellion research lab. There must be some testing.
Nana, are you able to determine its location?
Yes, but it will take some time.
Get started.
Hey, X. Something up?
Yeah. Got a transmission from the Colonel.
What up, gamers? T.U.G here. This is episode 23 of the Ultimate Let's Play Mega Man X Command Mission. Just got back from my shopping trip. Haven't been really done much in terms of weapons, although I did get Axel the Revolver Barrel, which now does a quadruple attack. I've also got the Massive Lance Beta for Massimo, and the Drill Arm for Cinnamon. I've also switched out one of her sub-weapons. She now has a virus missile. I did spend a lot of my money on new force metals, so I got a lot of WE plus 5s and plus 10s. Did a little bit of creation with Cinnamon. Here's what everyone has now. Yeah, I gave Cinnamon a lot of these. Not using up a lot of her immunity slots there. Anyway, as you saw at the beginning of the episode, Zero's not with us anymore. Let's see what's going to happen next.
Image analysis complete. The structure is probably near the Ares Valley in southwest Giga City.
Judging by the size of it, it would seem likely that there's some major research going on there.
A secret lab, huh? Sounds like fun. Let's check it out.
Okay, so we've got our destination for this chapter here. I want to pick up my guys from the deployments there, see how they did. Looks like everybody's back. Well, got a little bit. Hey, we got the Lograno key, so that'll open up a secret area back in the first area of the game. I'll probably go back there later, maybe in a future episode. All these guys got back. Not much. I do believe there's another key we can get, because later on in the game, we're going to be getting some new hyper modes, specifically for X, and when we get him back, Zero. And I will show that off at least, because their second hyper modes are, well, they're amazing. That's really the only word I can think of to describe it. And I think, Tiana Camp is where I got to go to find the key, and I think also this area. Well, we'll see what happens. Might as well search the old fat factory with my remaining guys here. Now, I know there's quite a few in the next episode. Or, I'm sorry, the next area we're going to be going to. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get all of them, because, again, some of them do require parts to work. I guess we'll see what happens. We're now heading to the Gimialla Mine. Okay, we're at the level 1 shaft entrance to start things off. And we got a cutscene.
The lab's somewhere around here.
Right. I don't imagine the Rebellion Army will let us sneak in easily.
Must be something important inside. Let's go.
You.
It's about time.
Haven't seen him since episode 2. He turned on us at the beginning of the game. That was Shadow. We're beginning Chapter 6, The Meaning of Friendship. Alright. It's pretty straightforward so far. Already we got a safe spot and some items. An Ultra Fire, an Ultra Blizzard, and an Ultra Thunder. And we're going to go ahead down to the next floor already. At least this does give us some opportunities to save. So what happened to me in the last area where I got stuck fighting a boss with only half my available sub-tanks does not happen again. Can't believe that happened to me. Somehow I pulled off a victory. Oh, we got a DOA Protection Force Metal. I think that's a force metal that protects you from one-hit knockout attacks. Go ahead and get these items here. A couple of figure tokens. I'll come back here later. I want to check what's on the other side first. And we got our first battle of this chapter. Oh, it looks like we got a new liquid glob enemy. As well as an old enemy that we're quite familiar with. That guy with the flame ray. Go ahead and mess him up with the charge collider. Still needs a little bit more there. Got the crack to appear. That should wear him down a bit. Something that do a little bit more damage, Marino. Flame ray coming. Hopefully not too damaging. I think I got the perfect attack for the Liquid Glob here. I'll have Axel use the Wild Django ability. Thunder against water. Let's see what it does. Still not quite enough for a final strike. Giga Blizzard. Ooh, that hurt. Axel's in the yellow now. Oh. I'm an idiot. I forgot. Fire heals that guy. I can't believe I did that.
Go down.
That be enough for a final strike? Yes.
Here we go. Final strike.
Awesome. I'm just gonna take out this guy. And it's like new quadruple attack of Axel's there.
Next.
And Marino deals the finishing touch. Did not expect that battle to take that long. Massimo leveled up. And that's that anti-lock again. I apparently have maximum anti-lock, so I can't carry anymore, so it'll keep reappearing until I actually pick it up. Alright. Since I am near a save point, I'll go ahead and burn a sub-tank here. I do believe quite a few enemies will drop at least some tank energy upon defeat. Let's see what we can find in here. A couple of doors. Let's see what we have to deal with here. Oh, seems like an easy fight.
Charge shot! Now!
Looks like a nurse mentor there. I'm gonna let Massimo come in here. So I think I have to use a melee attack on this guy anyway. That way I've got one shooter and one melee attacker. I have a feeling we'll be running into these guys a lot. Maybe you've been wanting to say that for a while, Massimo. This guy can do some damage too.
Here goes
nothing. We really need to rely on a little X-Fire here. It's already doing quadruple digit damage there. Looks like he's falling over. Still not taking a lot of damage from melee attacks.
Behold!
Let's see how he likes the laser of Massimo.
Stay down.
Boom. Good shot, Massimo.
Need more power.
Cinnamon got action sugar power up there. One more heart to her maximum amount there. Looks like we got a bunch of rocks blocking the way, and I think a mechanoloid over there. You know, it's probably a good spot to level up if just those guys gave a little bit more experience. So yeah, that was a broken mechanoloid there. I see an item in the back there. That battle ended with one charge shot from X. Got to build LE. Give someone 10 more LE points there. Can't go through there. We're blocked. So let's check the other corridor. Alright, Axel just leveled up. He's at level 19 now. He's actually the highest level of my team right now. So I'm going to go ahead and put him in, as well as Spider. Because I seem to be running into those bat bones quite a bit. Yeah, I'm going to battle the Bat Bones, but I think I'm going to leave the Mentors alone. They seem to be in more trouble than they're worth. And what do we got in here? Apparently another battle.
Run away, everybody!
FME. Alright, I think that's all we can get in this room. So I'm gonna head back from whence we came. That door is blocked off. Anything we can get in here? Figure token. Seems like a giant Y path there.
Eat this.
Good card, eh?
Tell you, those bat bones, they're easy to beat, but they're getting relentless right now. Another item, another figure token. Let's see if the item in here is a figure token as well. And once you know it, another figure token. Okay. I think I've covered everything here. And I can't go through here yet. I think that'll actually take me back down to the third floor. Got this liquid glob to deal with. I'll go ahead and hit him with Wild Django. Just give him a vicious pounding with shots here. Let's see what kind of hand I can get with Spider here. Got eights and kings. No improvement.
How's that?
And I don't think X-Fire is going to work too well here. Let's go with a generic attack. Yeah, he can apparently heal himself a little bit after every turn. Ultra Stream. Ooh.
That wasn't too bad.
I'm starting to run low on time here, so I'm going to go ahead and call it quits. And, next episode, we're going to check the other side of that hallway. I'm going to go ahead and save now. So until then, I'm T.U.G. Later, gamers.